When a writing is connected, it is known as connected writing. When three or more letters are frequently connected, it is known as connected writing. And if you lift your pen to dot the I or to cross the T, it is part of the connection only. If you lift the pen for dotting the I or crossing the T, it will not be treated as disconnection. It will be treated as connected writing. That is not treated as disconnected writing. One more thing which we are supposed to note here is, people who dot the I or cross the T after writing the word frequently come late or go late anywhere or what they have planned for. In the sense, suppose you have planned to get out of your house at 4:25 and you are a writer who writes the word complete and then dot the I and cross the T. Then this person, instead of getting out of the house at 4:25, this person would get out of the house at 4:27. Because this person thinks, he thinks that he'll complete this, he'll complete this, he'll complete this, and then do some very small jobs and get out of the house. Those sequence of things make him slightly late. And that slight late is not late, not necessarily late, but it forces them to go or reach some place later than what they have planned for. If they have planned to reach here at 3:27, they'll reach here by 3:35. Because they complete the thing and then they go back to cross the T and to dot the I. How would you know that this person has dotted the I and crossed the T late? Because the moment there's a connection after the T, then he has not dotted the T, crossed the T then. If there's a gap, he has dotted the I there and then. If there's no gap, then he has dotted late. I know people who write complete page and then go back and cross line by line T's and dot the I's after completing the page.